It costs nothing to become a Christian, but it costs everything to be a Christian. Only those who are truly bound to Jesus Christ are truly free. Therefore, a Christian who claims to be a Christian and claims the promises of God should obey the command of God. If you claim to be a Christian and claim the promises of God, you must always learn to obey the word of God. Our topic this morning is believe in the Lord and it shall be well with you. Believe in the Lord and it shall be well with you. Believe in the Lord. If you believe in the Lord, it shall be well with you. Believe and you will see miracles. Believe and you see breakthroughs. Believe and you see the light shining upon your life. Believe and you will see great and multitude of blessings pouring in upon your life. Just believe. Will you believe the Lord for the miracle this morning that you're going to be healed completely from every sickness and disease? Will you believe the Lord that very tumor, that very cancer, that very blood problem, whatever they are, that they are going to leave your body and be gone? Will you believe the Lord that very thyroid, that very migraine, sore throat, back pain, spinal pain, waist pain, knee pain, that they are going to leave your body and be gone because God said so? Will you believe the Lord that very poverty in your family is going to be gone and you are going to see abundant riches of God's blessings upon your life? Will you believe the Lord that very blockade upon your life, which devil has used to stop your progress, is going to be removed and you are going to see a breakthrough in the name of Jesus? Will you believe the Lord that those things that try to keep you behind bars all these years, one thing or the other, that they are going to leave your life? They are going to get out of you. Those inferiority complex. Some also are suffering from superiority complex. And those powers that try to make you believe that you are being discriminated against. Are you going to believe the Lord that this morning you are going to be set free and you are going to see yourself as a child of God? The Bible says in the book of Ephesians chapter 2, in verse 10, it said that we are God's workmanship, that you are going to be also ambassador of Christ wherever you are, shining for Jesus, declaring his goodness, and say, for me to live is Christ, to die is gain. Turn your Bible a moment in the book of Psalms, chapter 18. Book of Psalms 18. Psalms 18, verses 2 through 6. Psalms 18, verses 2 through 6. The Lord is my rock and my fortress and my deliverer, my God, my strength, in whom I will trust, my shield and a horn of my salvation, my stronghold. Let's stop there a moment before we continue. The Lord is my rock. That is what the Lord is to you. It's like personalized. The Lord is your rock. The Lord is your fortress and your deliverer. Nothing can stand before you because your God is your rock. Your God is your fortress. Your God is your deliverer. Regardless of what you're going through in life, it does not matter the situation you're in. Just believe God that I am a child of God because the Lord is my rock, my strength. He is my deliverer. He delivers me from every part of the enemy. He delivers me from the plans of the evil ones. He delivers me from everything because I believe. When Prophet Isaiah was writing in the book of Isaiah, chapter 7, verse 9, he said, if you do not believe, you will not be established. If you do not believe, you will not be established. Therefore, you got to believe. You got to believe. In the book of 2 Chronicles, chapter 20, verse 20, the Bible said, If you believe, you shall be established. Therefore, if you believe, you will receive your miracle. If you believe, you will receive your breakthrough. If you receive, you will see the power of God moving through your life. You become a blessing to people. Nothing will stop your career. Nothing will stop those things that God has planned for you. No one will stop your promotion. No one will stop your business from flourishing because the Lord is your deliverer. He will deliver you from all the plans of the enemy. He will deliver you from all the works of the devil. He will deliver you from sickness and diseases. He will deliver you from everything that the devil has coined against you. That's what he says. I believe the Bible, and this is true. And when you believe, you will never conspire against your brother or your sister. You will never have a fierce heart. You will never be a negative thinker or a negative person in your perspective. You always give room for accommodation, for tolerance. You always think before you talk, reason before you act, because every move you make can affect somebody somewhere. If you know that, you never put God to shame. Because every mistake you make will devastate some people. It continues. My God, my strength, in whom I will trust, my shield and the horn of my salvation, my stronghold. Hallelujah. That's what he says. The Lord is your strength. He's your shield. He protects you from every power of the enemy. Every weapon of the enemy will never touch you. When Prophet Isaiah was writing in the book of Isaiah, chapter 54, verse 17, he said, no weapon formed against you shall prosper. Why? Because the Lord has shielded you with his presence. When the devil shoots his arrow, it doesn't touch you. When they fire you, it won't reach you. Why? Because the Lord is your shield. He has protected you. You will see the arrow of the enemy falling but not touching you. Because the Lord is your shield. He is your strength. The Lord is your stronghold. No one can pull you down. No matter what the enemy plan, when they plan, we make sure your ministry will collapse. You tell them, when you say those things, my ministry is flourishing. Because the Lord is your stronghold. Without your faith in God, you can't stand the wiles of the enemy. Therefore, when Apostle Paul was writing to the church of Ephesus, in the book of Ephesians chapter 6, in verse 10 down to 18, he says, finally, brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his mind. Be strong. Put on the whole armor of God. You are not fighting against physical being. You are fighting against unseen forces, powers of the enemy, wicked spirit. Put on the whole armor of God that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the enemy. Why? Because you believe. Because you believe. Put on the whole armor. Though we walk in flesh, we do not war. We do not battle against the flesh, for the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but they are mighty through God, pulling down stronghold. I always tell people, pull down your stronghold, otherwise your stronghold will pull you down. Pull down that anger, otherwise it will destroy your ministry and destroy your life. I shared this many times with you. I'm yet to see anyone who can be angry like me. I'm yet. I used to be a very angry man. Until I told the Lord, unless you deal with this anger, otherwise it will not only destroy me, it will destroy the ministry and destroy those around me. The problem of mankind is that we never learn how to know what is our weakness. Find out what is the weakness in your life and deal with it before that weakness will deal with you. If you believe, deal with that weakness before it deals with you. To deal with you with a dirty blow, and before you know it, you're finished. Then you say, but the Lord, why did he allow it to happen? God said, I warn you. Were you not warned? God can warn you through his word. God can warn you through a servant, his servant. God can warn you also directly. So deal with it. Deal with it. Put on the whole armor, the helmet of salvation, the breastplate of righteousness, the truth, which is the belt, the gospel of peace, maintaining peace, pursuing peace wherever you are, which is your full shield. Holding the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. That's the only offensive weapon. And the shield of faith. Six of them. So you can press on. Don't be a fault-finding person. Rejoice, take your rest. Give benefit of doubt in every situation. In case. I always warn people, you may slap your face. It does not matter how defensive you can be, you may end up slapping your face. If you believe, a lot of things comes. You become an exemplary person. Victory everywhere. People talk about victory. Listen, there's no victory unless you go to the battle. Believing. Believe in the Lord. Trust in Him. You trust Him for people. You don't trust people, but you trust God for people. That's what the Bible declared in the book of Psalm 125, verse 1 and 2. Those who trust in the Lord will be like Mount Zion, which cannot be removed, but abides forever. As Jerusalem is surrounded by mountains, so the Lord surrounds His people now and forevermore. Isaiah 26, verses 3 and 4. Thou, O Lord, will keep us in perfect peace because we trust in Thee. Trust ye in Jehovah, for He is your everlasting strength. Woe unto that man who trusts in man. Jeremiah 17, 5 and 6. Don't trust, but trust God. Don't trust on the arm of flesh. Trust God for people. There are blessings that come upon you when you begin to trust God for people. You know why people don't trust people? Because they don't trust themselves. They don't even trust God. How to trust themselves? It continued. I will call upon the Lord, who is worthy to be praised, so shall I be saved from my enemies. Sounds very familiar. You know that song? I will call upon the Lord, and so shall He save me from my enemies. He's worthy to be praised. Call upon Him. Call upon Him in every situation you are. Believe Him, and you shall do what? It shall be well with you. Call upon the Lord. Why do we call upon the Lord? Because we have no one else to call upon. We have no one to lean on. That's why we call upon Him. We don't call upon Him because we call upon Him in our pride. No, go before Him. Humble yourself and say, Lord, I call upon You. The Bible declared, the psalmist, David the king, declared in the book of Psalms, chapter 31, verse 15, he said, my time is in Your hand. My time is, because he know how to call upon God and tell Him, my time is in Your hand. In the book of Psalm chapter 55, verse 22, he said, call upon God, for He will not allow the righteous to be moved. Jeremiah 33, verse 3, call upon Him and He'll show you great and mighty things which you do not know. Call upon Him. It does not matter what you're going through, just call upon the Lord, and He will answer you. Oh, my joy is this. He says, before even I call upon Him, He will answer. Before you call upon Him, He will answer. Verse 4, the pangs of death surround me, and the floods of uncleanness make me afraid. The sorrows of Sheol surrounded me, the snares of death confronted me. In my distress, I call upon the Lord and cry out to my God. He heard my voice from His temple, and my cry came before Him, even to His ears. Even when you go through terrible time, when the pang of death surrounds you, when all false accusations come upon you, when people begin to find fault on you, when they begin to tell you what you're supposed to do, which you did not do, but they don't remember what you did, which they did not know. What did the Bible say? I call upon Him and He heard me. My prayer come even to His ears. I want to encourage you on something. Even if you're disappointed with people, don't bear grudge. I don't like to use that word when I'm talking to people. I say, oh, I'm disappointed. But it's very common with people. I'm just disappointed. Do you know that's a strong word? It weakens the receiver. Oh, I'm just disappointed about you. It's a very strong word. It makes the receiver to be so weakened. Oh, but it's very easy. I'm just disappointed. I shared with you some time ago. Somebody came to me and said, Pastor, I'm very straightforward. I don't like to beat about the bush. I'm very straightforward. I said, Sister, no problem. It's good to be straightforward, but the thing is, if people are straightforward, you can take or not. Either they cannot take it. But we always say, I'm very straightforward. Talk is cheap. Can you accept people being straight to you? Woo! If somebody says, I'm so disappointed about you, won't you fire back? Be careful with the words you use. For every idle word man shall speak, he shall give account of it. Make your word to be soft. Bible says, soft word takes away wrath. The words you use are very important in life. When you are talking to people, be careful the kind of words you use. Yes, emotion come, anger arouse. But what about the spirit? Bible says two things are fighting in you, the spirit and the flesh. I always encourage brothers and sisters, think before you talk. Don't talk out of emotion, otherwise you will hurt people. Yes. You will disappoint people. Think before you talk. Use appropriate words, not inappropriate words. Don't speak just because you feel, I'm just fed up, I'm just angry. Ooh, no. You are a Christian. You are not, though we are in the world, we are not part of the world. I can see what happened to King David. Turn your Bible a moment in the book of Psalms again. Now, chapter 42. Psalms 42. Look at verse 11. Why are you cast down, O my soul? And why are you disquieted within me? Hope in God, for I shall yet praise him, the help of my countenance and my God. What a statement. You see, King David here, he was really disturbed within a time of distress. He was totally distressed. And he says, why are you cast down, O my soul? Have you ever been in a distressed position before? When everything seems to be meaningless. When it seems a man has failed you with his vile and wild promises. It seems everything within you is totally dislocated. You are full of anger, full of disappointment, full of distress. It's like no one else to trust. And that time we will claim we only trust God. It's not true. I tell you the truth. If you really trust God at that time, you will never overreact. See, many people don't know what it means to trust God. When you trust God, you will never overreact. Rather, you say, Lord, to you I submit. Help me. Trusting God does not make you to become rude to people. No. That it makes you to be a calmed person in a stormy world. Calm. In a stormy world. Rather, you can ask yourself this question, just as the psalmist said, why are you cast down, O my soul? Why are you disquieted in me? David, the son of God, made it clear. The Bible said in 1 Samuel chapter 30, when everything seems to have been stolen and taken away from him, including his family, David strengthened himself in the Lord. In verse 6, 1 Samuel chapter 30, verse 6, he strengthened himself in the Lord. That is how it's supposed to be. He did not go out and say, I'm going to fire them. I'm going to tell them what I feel. I'm going to lash out my anger. I'm going to show them. No. He strengthened himself in the Lord. Church, this Bible is truth. If we will live by it, we'll fight with nobody. Our problem is we read it, we act opposite. And we try to use Bible to cover our insecurity and all our flawed characters. We quote Bible, but do we act accordingly? This is it. When we're in distress, that's when we want to show our anger. That's when we want to, I have to tell you how I feel. Uh-oh. If somebody tells also you how they feel, how will you be? But when you trust the Lord for situation, you're supposed to be calm in the midst of stormy weather. Do you know people are watching you? How you react over situations. People think that love is always, oh, pampering. No, love attracts rebuke. Stop. Don't talk like that. Don't do like this. That's not good. Still without remorse. The psalmist said, why are you disquieted? I hope in God, for I shall yet praise him, the help of my countenance and my God. That's what it says. Why are you cast down, oh my soul? Let me be lifted up now. Don't be disquieted in me, but hope in God. Saints of God, God who fed the people of Israel in the wilderness is able to feed you. It doesn't matter what you're going through now. Maybe you see yourself down. You see your soul disquieted. You see the pang of hell around you. Remember, God will not fail you. In the book of Esther chapter 16, verse 15 through 18, God fed his people. God Almighty granted the desire of Hannah after she poured out her heart. God granted that very request. 1 Samuel chapter 1, verse 17 through 21. Pour out your heart to God. Whatever is troubling you, whatever that made you to be like a chicken, tell God, I pour them out. I look at that woman. She was mocked and ridiculed because she couldn't have a child. She went and poured out her heart to God. Even the priest and the prophet mistook her rather. Yet, she poured out her heart and God granted that request. God heard the voices of these servants. His servants, Abednego, Shadrach, and Meshach, in the fiery furnace and attended to their need. Daniel chapter 3, verse 17 through 27. God came in that fiery furnace and proved what made him to be God. Church, it's time for us to know the situation you are going through, God wants to come there. He wants to come there and give you a handshake, embrace you, comfort you. If you are not in that situation, how will you experience God? Any situation you are going through is for you to experience God in a special way. Just as Abednego, Shadrach, and Meshach did. While we are going through that furnace, the king ran and came. Hey, I told you to put three people. How come four? Oh, the fourth one is Son of God. Yes. He wants to be there with you. Every situation you are in is an opportunity for miracle. Can I hear amen? Every situation you are in is an opportunity for you to see God's supernatural power in demonstration. I shared with you one time when I went to a place, it was really cold and there was no heater in my room. I SMS my wife and said, well, take care of the children because of what I'm going. Because I can't take it tonight about the cold. I lay down and slept. Son of God walked into that very room. I didn't know when I took out my shirt, I was sweating in the morning. Oh, then I knew this must be God in this zero temperature. Same thing in every situation, there is room for testimony. 2 weeks ago, I shared with you, I traveled to the States. The first night for that meeting, my first time in that church, I told this congregation, I said, after preaching, I said, something's going to happen. Stand on your feet, church. Everybody ask for one thing. Ask for one thing. You know, we believers, when we hear ask for one thing, we ask two by faith. When you say one, you know. That's Christians. And that they won't remember that the spirit of greed. I say, ask for one thing. Some will say by faith 2. Some will say by faith 9. I say, just one thing. We are believers of one thing. Apostle said, this one thing. David said one thing. I said, please, don't tell me that by faith 2. I say only one. I want them. Don't tell me by faith I ask 2. No, please, that would be by fear and greed. I say one thing. And it was on Wednesday night. And when I made everybody stand on their feet, I said, okay, ask one thing, close your eyes. From this Wednesday to Sunday, something is going to happen. If you don't receive, you know I'm not a servant of God. You can see somebody saying, it's like, okay, if I don't get it, you had it. You can literally see it. You can literally see it. But it's on their faces. You can literally see it. I say, God, you have to do this miracle. Please, Lord, override their doubts. Just for the sake of your poor servant, we pray. In Jesus' name, they say, amen. We left. On Thursday, the pastor of the church began to call. Pastor, my phone is jammed. People are calling that things are happening. Uh-oh, praise the Lord, that phone are jamming because of the miracles. See, they believe. God's people, it does not matter the situation you're going through. Will you believe God that, yes, Lord, even as you attended to the three Hebrew boys in that very furnace, you are going to attend to me. What about Daniel? The Bible declared very clearly in the book of Daniel, chapter 6, verse 16 through 23, that Jehovah God stepped into that very lion's den and stopped the lions from touching Daniel. Don't you know that God is just waiting to protect you from those hands and those evil? Those things that devil has planned against you, God is waiting to protect you. It does not matter. It might be even bankruptcy charge. I'm telling you, if you believe, you will see the miracle of God in your life. It does not matter what they are, that God is able to sustain you. Even that debt you don't know how to pay, will you believe that that debt has become a lion's den for you? And God is going to come in and set you free from that attack of the enemy. Can I hear amen? This is, do you believe? Do you believe? God Almighty heard the prayer of his servant Elijah. Oh, I like to read about Elijah. In the book of 1 Kings chapter 18, verse 21 through 40. At your time, you can read. The Bible told that was a time when the land was totally ridden and destroyed by apostasy. The people of God had totally forgotten God because of the evil king they had. The Bible says when the righteous rules, the people enjoy, but when the unrighteous rule, the people suffer. Evil king was oppressing and totally destroying God's people through apostasy. And what happened? There's a son of God, a prophet of God. We need to have servants of God who will never fear any power of hell, who dare to speak the truth, come what may, and stand for it. And the Bible told us in 1 Kings chapter 18 from verse 21 down to 43, what did the Bible say there? The Bible declared very clearly that Elijah stood and said, you prophet of Baal, come. Now call upon your God. Let your God hear you. The Bible said all the prophet of Baal begin to call upon their God, whip themselves, poke themselves, begin to do all kind of rituals. And Elijah make a mockery of them and said, shout, maybe he's sleeping. Blow trumpet, maybe he's gone to market. You see, making mockery of them because he knows that Baal is not God. Idol is not God. And he knew that Jehovah God of Israel is the real God. I want to tell you, God's people, our God is real. And what happened? When he opened his mouth, when he come to his turn, and he opened his mouth and prayed, divine fire came down and licked up the water and licked up the sacrifice because he is God's servant. God's people, you may not be recognized in this world, but God recognizes you. Can I hear amen? That's what matters. And that's what you need to follow. It's not your so-called degrees you have, long degrees. Our God hears our prayer. Our Heavenly Father, who calmed the wave of the sea, still can calm our stormy life, even this day, and speak peace. Jehovah Rapha is the one who heals all diseases and sicknesses. The Bible declared in the book of Psalms a moment. I would like us to read this. Psalm 107. Turn with me in the book of Psalm 107. Look at verse 19 and 20. It said, then they cried out to the Lord in their trouble, and he saved them out of their distress. He sent his word and healed them and delivered them from their destructions. Oh, hallelujah. They cried out to God. Have you ever cried out to God for your sickness, for your disease? I want to tell you something. God wants to use you to heal people. It does not matter where the sickness, put your hand there and command the sickness to get out, because your body is the temple of God. The Bible declared in 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 16 and 17, and also 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 19 and 20, you are God's temple. God bought you with price. Satan has no right to inflict you with sickness and disease. Command the sickness to go, because the Bible said in the book of Matthew chapter 8, verse 17, that the prophecies of Isaiah may be fulfilled. Therefore, Jesus took upon himself all our sicknesses and infirmities. 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 24 says the same thing. Isaiah chapter 53, verse 5 said, by his stripes we are healed. Therefore, command that sickness to leave. That is your right, because God gave you that right. Jesus declared in the book of Luke chapter 10, verse 19, behold, I give you authority. Everybody say authority. One more time, authority. One more time, authority. Yes, he gave you authority to trample over all the powers of the enemy. Serpents and scorpions, and over all. He did not say sub all the powers of the enemy, and nothing shall harm you. Therefore, exercise that authority and let the devil get out of your life. Very clearly it's written there. The Lord God of Israel, who shut the lion's mouth, will also shut the lion's mouth against you. Saints of God, our God never changes. You must know that. Our God never changes. Hebrew declared it. The Hebrew writer declared it. That our God never changes. He the same yesterday, today, and forever. He never changes. His mercy never ends, and his loving kindness reaches to every one of us if only we can believe. Can we believe? That's all. Can we believe? Why should we doubt the power of the Almighty God? Why? Why should we get discouraged and believe the false and deceiving suggestion of devil? The worst defeat is self-defeat. I always encourage people about this. Don't ever get discouraged and begin to believe the suggestion of devil. Oh, it's like that. Oh, it might look like that. It is not what you think it is to be. Another thing that can kill you in a ministry or in your life is rash decisions. That will kill Saul. Why did you do this? Oh, because I saw the people have left me, so I have no one. So I thought the Philistines are coming, then let me do sacrifice. Were you commanded to do so? No. That's why I continue to say, whatever you do in life, this book is dementing. Go through it. Don't just be selective. What you want to know, what you want to feel. Before you take any decision, back to the Bible. Back on your knees. Seek God first. That emotion rises. You feel it. It boils like one mosquito in you. No. If it comes like a mosquito, take spiritual shelter. Don't act foolishly. That's why Samuel the prophet said, you have acted foolishly. Now the Lord would have established your ministry or your kingdom, but now the Lord has taken away from you. I've learned a lot as I walk with God. Don't try to twist God's hands. Before you take any decision in life, back to the Bible, back on your knees. Find out the truth. Lord, let me see the truth. Otherwise, I'll make mistake. Mistake is always easy to be made, but it costs you a lot. The devil and his hosts will always tell you that there is no hope, no future, no reason for life. The future is bleak and there is no way out of the wilderness. But don't forget, Jeremiah chapter 30, verse 16 and 17. God said there is hope for your future. God said, wipe away the tears from your eyes. Weep no more. There is hope. The only person who doesn't have hope in the world is a dead person. As long as there is life, there is hope. God can change things around. God can turn things around. Because you are special to God. You are the one God wants to use. There is hope. There is hope. All these lies of the devil are there to deceive you, but don't take it. God's people, do you know our worries are the Lord's concern? Whatever that worries you is God's burden. He wants to take care of that. What bothers you most is the Lord's burden, not ours. That's why in my own life, when those worries will come, you know what I do? I resign to God. I totally surrender to God. Lord, these worries are not for me. It's your worry. Take care of it. If you don't help me, the weight of the burden will kill me. I shared this a couple of times with you. About 2 or 3 years back. No, 4 years back. When the burden was so much, I remembered how my wife scolded me. Do you think God will let you carry something he knows that you cannot carry? See, that woke me up. Made me to realize I am unnecessarily carrying burden which belongs to God. I don't need to be worried about that. God has to take care of it. All I need to do is to put my knees down and cry out to God. That's all. But it does not mean when you are crying out to God means you are angry with people. Or you begin to suspect people. It's because of this person. If you succeed in ministry, it's because you trust the Lord. If you don't succeed, it's not because of anybody. It's you. Don't blame anyone. Many times we live life of irresponsibility and we blame somebody else. I tell God, let me not in my pride go out of your will. But let me always be at your will. When I'm at your will, it does not matter what I go through, you are still watching me. You know my comfort? Whatever I do, that God is watching me. So when I'm going, I say, I meet this on the road. I say, Lord, know this is there. So if I hit my leg there, Lord, you know it's there. Why did I hit it? Okay, you have to heal me. But if I go unnecessarily go and hit it, well, you have to go through the pain. You have to go through the pain. Yeah, the Lord will help you, but the pain, you have to go through it. That's one thing people never learn. They say, after God is there, God will help you. Yes, God will help you, but you have moved out of what, out of the plan of God concerning your life. Therefore, you are going to face the consequences, although you're not going to die, yes, but you will go through a lot, which you might regret. Remember what happened to Moses. Moses knew that God had chosen him to lead the people of Israel, but he was in a haste. He went and killed somebody. God did not call him to kill anybody. Because of that mistake, he did not die, yes, but that had to delay his ministry for another 40 years. You know what he went through? That's why in that wilderness, when he saw the burning bush, he couldn't mean, what is this? What is this sight? When God called him and told him he had to go back, he refused. How can I tell them that you have sent me? It took me another 40 years before he get back to the ministry again. And that 40 years was wasted because of what rash decision. That is why it's important. God's people, be careful. Ministry is not like secular business. There are a lot of, if Ministry is a spiritual business, then it is governed by spiritual laws that you need to keep your eyes on and be careful, especially in the area of humility. 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 And being careful of what you say. Let's continue. Whenever we cry out to God, God hears us. When we moan and groan, the Lord understands the pain in our heart. When we are in sorrow and grief, it touches the heart of God. The only one we can trust is the Lord of the universe, the King who moves the heart of man. Do not let your trust in the Lord be shaken. Don't allow your trust to be shaken. Your trust in God must not be shaken, because God is able to do all things for us. In Ephesians chapter 3 verse 20 says, He's able to do more than we ask and more than we think. He's able to do exceedingly more, much more than we ever believe even to be done. We must not yield to discouragement. I always encourage and exhort people about this. Don't yield to discouragement, regardless of what you're going through. Do not be lost in the overwhelming situation before you. Whatever you're facing, don't be lost in the overwhelming situation. Believe that God is going to do something for you. Believe that God is going to make a way where there's no way. Believe that God is going to give you water in the desert. Believe that God is going to give you shelter in the midst of storm. That God will be there for you. Always believe that. Believe that. Believe it. Believe it. Believe it. Don't doubt it. Believe on the Lord and be encouraged that God will stand by you in every situation. Pour out your heart to the Lord. Trust in Him and He will change that situation. Pour out your heart. His name is Jehovah Rapha, the Lord who heals us. If you're going through sickness, believe that God who heals us will heal you. His name is Jehovah Jireh, the Lord who provides for every mission God has for you. He had made provision. I talk with personal experience. He had always made provision for that. If it's not immediately, something has been done. If God did not raise somebody to meet you at the airport, God had made somebody to meet you at the other side. This is how it goes. We can't determine how He does His work. All we need to do is keep on believing, keep on trusting, and He will prove Himself. This is something you must know. Believe Him, believe Him, believe Him. His name is Jehovah Shalom, the Lord, our peace. He will always maintain peace with, allow peace to reign in our relationship with people. Remember, the Bible declared in the book of Hebrews, chapter 12, verse 14, pursue peace and holiness, for without which no eye shall see the Lord. Live in peace and not in pieces. Always reach out. Now, many of us talk about ministry, we don't talk about relationship. For me, what comes first is relationship, not ministry. I always tell people, don't break the bridge when you cross over, because you might need the bridge back. Not in your pride, you try to break the rice bowl. You might need it again. You must always remember this. It has been God's will for us to maintain relationship. There are many people, their relationship with people is cold, not warm. I always ask this question to myself. My relationship with that person, is it the same what it used to be? If it's not, then what happens? Something must have gone amiss. Don't go in your pride and destroy good relationship with people. You might need it again. You might end up paying a costly price for it. What comes first is relationship, not ministry. He, Jehovah Shammah, the Lord who is ever present for us. Whatever you are, whatever thing you're doing, in anything, in every situation, He's always there. He's there. If you know that we have Jehovah Shammah as our God, you'll be conscious of what you're doing. You never let yourself be so out of sin very easily. You become conscious. You know, many people don't commit sin today because they don't have the opportunity. Not because they are feeling God's presence. But you see, a man who fears God has nothing else to fear. But a man who doesn't fear God is worse than a murderer. He can kill. Do you fear God? Jehovah Shammah. His presence is always there for us. He's our Adonai, the sovereign Lord and our master. So in every situation you go through, if you remember that Adonai is your sovereign Lord, you will never be moved, because situation cannot rise above your Adonai. In the book of Isaiah, chapter 54, verse 10, say, mountains and hills shall depart, but his kindness and mercy will never depart from you. Therefore, your Adonai is there. He will not allow your problems to overwhelm you. Problems come and go, but our Lord, our God, remains same. That's my joy. So when you see problems come, just be quiet. Bible declared in the book of Psalm 46:10, be thou still and know that I am God. Be still. That problem will come and it will go with the wind. But our God remains the same. So don't be carried away by the wind of problem. That is why many people don't have good relationship with people. That's why they cannot flourish in their ministry. That's why they cannot stand firm for God. Because when problems come, they get swept away by these problems. They begin to jitter and shake. You forget to know all these things will come. But Jesus said, behold, I have overcome the world for you. John 16:33. Let's praise the Lord. He is our God, our hope. Trust in Him. Have confidence in Him, for He is your strength. And let Him be our great helper in a time of trouble. In a time of trouble. You know why many of us shake when we face some problems? Because we always see our problem with a magnifying glass. But the Bible says, I'll magnify the Lord. I tell you one secret. Problem will surely come, but our God will be by us. Problem will come and it will go, but our God will not go. He will always stand by us. That's one thing you must always know. Whenever you face any situation, any problem, it does not matter what they are. Always remember, this problem has come and it will go, but my God is with me. Always remember that. If you remember that, you will never be carried away by your problems. Your problem will not sweep you away. That is why Prophet Isaiah declared in the book of Isaiah 43, in verses 1, 2, and 3, what did he say? He said, we belong to God. And again, when we go through the mountain, through the fire, we will not get burnt. When we go through the sea, we will not be swept away. When we go through the rivers, we will not sink. Because all these things will come and go. But our Lord, our God, remain the same. Heaven and earth shall pass away, but our God remain the same. Let us praise Him, for He is our God. His marvelous works and miracles are unprecedented. Therefore, we have to extol His name, declare His wondrous work. Hallelujah. For our God reigneth. That's what we believe. Because if you believe, remember the Bible declared in the book of Romans chapter 10 verse 11, if you believe, you will now be put to shame. If you believe this morning, whatever that situation is, you will not be the same again and you will never be put to shame. This is an assurance I'm proclaiming and declaring to you. If you believe, it does not matter what you're going through today. If you just believe, it shall be well with you. When you hear the voice of God, you don't hide in your heart.